Here he is, a philosopher, a writer, a comedian, a big man trapped in a thin man's body, the host of Vague But True, Tim Bedore. Well, thank you very much. I had a travel day from hell last weekend. My ride dropped me off at the Portland airport at 7:30 a.m. for a 10:30 a.m. flight to Los Angeles, but I didn't end up leaving Portland until 12:30 p.m. because the plane broke. The good news is it broke while we were on the ground. The bad news, 5 hours after getting to the airport, I was finally sitting on a plane headed to Sacramento to connect to San Jose, to connect to Los Angeles, because, quote, Mr. Bedore, that's the best we can do. No, that's not the best we can do. The best we can do is a foot massage in first class on the next direct flight out of Portland. If you're not going to do that, then please be honest and say, Mr. Bedore, we already have your money and you can't walk home from here. So shut up and enjoy Sacramento. If they would just say that, then we'd all understand the nature of our relationship and their employees won't go to hell for lying to me. Anyway, I'm finally sitting on a working plane. I'm a little jacked up, lots of anger, lots of tension. And for whatever reason, reached into the seat pocket in front of me and started browsing through that Skymall catalog that sells all those amazing gadgets.
Oh, yeah. Love it.
As I'm browsing, I began adding my own nasty little additions to each product slug line, which describes the product. And it made me feel good. For example, in the Skymall catalog, there's an ultrasonic device to stop annoying noise from your neighbor's pet. And the slug line was, the safe and effective way to solve your barking dog problem. To which I added, that doesn't involve poison meat or jail time. My blood pressure started sliding down to near normal. Carry a 12.5-foot telescoping ladder in the trunk of your car, because you never know when you might get stuck in traffic and want to hang yourself for just $339. My shoulders came down from around my ears. There was a picture of a backyard pool with a cooler sitting in an inner tube that was ringed by cup holders filled with cocktails. And the owner's name, Peterson, was stenciled on the side.
Sweet.
Personalized, free, insulated, floating cooler for the swimming alcoholic that doesn't want to be anonymous. My clenched fist started to release. Life-size World War I airplane propeller replica for the man who needs to buy just one last item to end his marriage. I started breathing normally. The first floating handset telephone, because whitewater rafters need to order pizza. Also handy for floating alcoholics who need more ice. I snort chuckled and woke up the person next to me. What's my point? If you're flying this summer and don't want to turn into a walking, talking muscle spasm, don't see yourself as an airline customer who has rights or human dignity. See yourself as being in divorce court. You're just trying to get out of there with as little financial and emotional damage as possible. And be sure to check out page 133 of the SkyMall catalog for the personalized garden bench to honor your dearly departed loved ones. In fond remembrance of Aunt Cora, who loved these ferns and wisteria and died at age 98 from an unknown bacteria. From Los Angeles, where insanity meets the sea, I'm Tim Bedore with Vague But True on the Bob and Tom Radio Network.
Bravo. Oh, that's great.